This is Mbali Sibabini Chandu. He is the upcoming fashion designer who is currently a third year student at CPUT and has achieved a minimum of his dreams so far, as he started a brand on his first year at CPUT, but he will explain further on that on the documentary. He is a very talented boy and has passion in fashion. He is also inspired by Ladumo Ngolo, who is from the Eastern Cape and is the founder of Maxhosa. Mbali is from the Eastern Cape as well. Hence, he is very inspired by the fashion designer who is successful, just like Maxhosa Ladumo Ngolo from the Eastern Cape.
I was born and raised in the Eastern Cape in a town called Mthatha. I grew up in Sibangweni, though. So you can say it's a village, but not that much of a village. And I'm currently doing my third year in fashion design at CPUT. And I'm a very good tailor, I can say. The day I fell in love with fashion. I don't think there was a day I ever fell in love with fashion. I can say that fashion fell in love with me, because I always see that I'm not the one that chases clothes, but clothes always have a way of coming to me. Clothes always like have a way of like you know, just combining themselves up for me, so when I get there they already combine, you know. I can like get vintage clothes and like modern clothes. You know what I mean? I can just mix them up, man. I feel like fashion does love me. It fell in love with me, not the other way around, though. Because what I can say about myself is that I'm industry, not an artist of the industry. You know what I mean? Because with my tailoring techniques, I know and I'm certain of, and I know 100% sure that I'm gonna make history. As my middle name says, Mbali, which means history. Thanks. That's a good question right there. When was it? Okay, I think it was back in 2017. I remember the day I was in front of the mirror. It was in the morning. I think it was past six or seven. I was looking at myself in the mirror, fixing my tie, and then my niece came to me. My niece Mila came to me, and she said, "Buti, you always spend so much time wearing your uniform." You see, that's when I knew that. At the time, I didn't know what I liked. But when she told me that, I just knew that I have a thing with my uniform. I had a deep connection with my school uniform. So going onwards, like they talked about it in the house that maybe I could do clothes, you know what I mean? Maybe I could find a good career in clothes. And at the time I looked at textiles and all of that, but I ended up in fashion where I am now. And looking back at that day, I can say that day was like, it will be my memory for, I don't know.
How I came up with my brand name, Chandu. I remember it was 2018,
when the thought came to me, like I should have a label called Chandu. I remember it was my first time being enrolled in fashion design, and at the time I had no label whatsoever, and I didn't know what I was gonna do in fashion, but I just knew that I was gonna make clothes. So when I was enrolled in fashion design, that's when I knew that I have to have a label. And as I am Chandu, you know, my surname is Chandu, so annually my family has a family gathering. So I saw an opportunity in that, like I could make clothes for my family only. At the beginning it was only for my family, like for everyone who's Chandu, to like when they go to the family gathering they can like be presentable in Chandu clothes. But as time went, you know what I'm saying, it was way more than just a family business or like family clothing line. It became more, it expanded to like my surrounding friends, and everyone became a member. And yeah. My worst day in fashion, it was 2018 when I was still in Bartowet. What happened was there was a pitch at school, and all the celebrities were there. Like there were about three celebrities, Candice Morisella, and I don't know the others. I just know that Candice Morisella was there. And what happened that I was the first one to pitch. Imagine, she called out my name like, Sibabini, come pitch. And that pitch I made was so stupid, it was so dumb, it was so out of line, it was so out of pocket. I don't know, I felt like dropping out the same day, you know what I mean? I felt stupid when I did that that pitch, because I don't know what I can say why, but yeah, it happened. And then after 2 years in fashion, what I pitched that day is what's gonna turn my life around. What would I like to achieve in this career? First of all, I'd like to see my brand in New York, you know what I mean? I'd like to see it in America. I'd like to spot someone wearing Chandu from head to toe in London. You know what I mean? My goal is to leave a legacy behind for my grandchildren, so that when they grow up, they can feed their grandchildren also from their surname. That's one thing that turns me on. Like, I know I could leave a legacy behind for them because it's a surname to them, you know. And yeah, man, I just like to see my brand going to places and having like equipment. Like buildings and all of that, like to be successful.